Hello everyone, Suslik Gaming here, and today we're gonna review Centurion Mk 5/1. Premium medium tank of 7.3 BR belongs to the British Tech 3. It is an Australian modification of regular Centurion Mk 3. The only difference between them, Australian version have extra armor at the frontal hull, night vision, extra two machine guns, one of them is high caliber, good for killing Italian Fiats, low repair cost, and don't have smoke grenades. There is also obviously a visual difference between them. The crew of this tank is probably the luckiest crew in the War Thunder. Australian Centurion looks like a Centurion that is about to go to a family trip. Just look at all this stuff. Food, tent, paint bucket, blanket, fuel, another bucket, basic tools, extra ammunition, spare wheel, and also extra storage filled with, I don't know, Anzac biscuits. By the way, not all of this stuff is useless. The spare wheels at the front of the hull actually adds up 20 millimeters of armor. One of the wheels actually saved my life once. Check this moment out. You can see the usage of this extra armor in this clip. T29 shots me. If I was regular Centurion, I would have been probably dead. But look at that. A wheel saves my life. Remarkable. Effective armor with the wheel jumps from 226 to 262. When wheel is destroyed, 30 mm of protection is gone. Also at the statistic, it says hull is 76. But if you open up the armor wheel at the hangar, you can see that Centurion has triple protection. The first plate is 76, then there is second plate and the wheel. Totally we have 262 mm of effective armor. Because of this fuels at the back, your barrel cannot go down. So you're pretty much dead if there is someone behind you. All of this extra stuff on your Centurion adds up 2 tons to your tank. If you never had a Centurion Mk 3 before, this tank once used to have 6.7 of BR with the other two tanks, FV202 and Kernavaran. Then Gaijin, to ruin this meta lineup, put them to 7.0. There were still meta at this BR. So developers made a final blow to finish the madness of the British high victor rate and increase the BR of Kernavaran and Centurion Mk 3 to 7.3. So if none of this happened, this new Australian Centurion would have been 6.7 of BR. So calling this vehicle a meta will be a total lie. It would have been meta at 6.7, but here, now, it's just playable. The only reason why this tank is playable, because it has a stabilizer that actually works, not like in T10A, the previous Battle Pass top award vehicle. And we have saber rounds. Same reloading time, same penetration as the other three tanks in this list. Britain is the only nation with stabilizer at this VR. That's why if you and enemy moving towards each other, you have a high chance to kill him first. Mobility-wise, Centurion is quite slow. Our cruising speed on the grass, 34 kph. Our top speed is 35. Reverse speed is 12 kph. So this top speed limitation is quite feelable when you're going down the hill. Minus 10 vertical guidance, enough to play from behind of the hill. Even though it's lower of BR, I still prefer to play with FV202. It has same characteristics as Australian Centurion, but with smoke grenades and rangefinder. So is this tank worth it? Absolutely yes. Compared to T10A, it is 100% worth it. You can use this vehicle with backup cards to research British Tech 3 without any problem. If you already researched this Tech 3, then sell it and buy a decent premium pack from other nation. There is nothing unique about this vehicle. It's just a premium Centurion Mk 3. So guys, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to check out my other reviews. As always, peace out.
Thank you.